Today we're out here on site with an existing well, and I'm going to give you a quick demonstration on how to wire up your WaterSecure system to your existing well pump. I'm also going to discuss a couple other options you have for using this WaterSecure system with a pro system or a tankless pressure pump. This is Mike with RPS Solar Pumps, and today it's a quick demo of how to install your WaterSecure system. WaterSecure makes it quick and easy to secure your water supply in the case of power outages or other natural disasters. It comes with what you see here. Here's our all-in-one inverter unit with a built-in maximum power point charge controller. This takes the power from our solar panels and charges the batteries that are sitting back behind here. Then with our easy to use plugs, we can simply plug it into our well pump. And if you have grid power or you have a generator handy, you can also plug it in to that power source in order to charge your batteries if you have extended number of cloudy days. Let me give you a quick overview of the different types of pumps this system works with. If you have one of our tankless pressure pumps, the WaterSecure option is a great upgrade if you need to do extended pumping times, say longer than 6 to 8 hours a day of pumping. This can support a larger battery bank, more charging capacity from our solar panels, and can allow the pump to run longer. The great thing about WaterSecure is all of the connections are connectorized. That means we can simply create a very small adapter plug, plug it into our WaterSecure connection, and that allows us to plug in our tankless pressure pump. This also allows us to use a 110 volt breakout plug in order to run our 110 volt loads. We can take this plug, plug it into our WaterSecure, and now we have two 110 volt AC output plugs where we could plug in, say, a small refrigerator or lighting in order to run AC loads. If you have one of our Pro Series controllers, we can also run our Pro Series controller with the AC output from the WaterSecure. Again, we just quickly make a little breakout plug, which allows us to plug in our Pro controller and run off of WaterSecure. You are going to want to make sure you size this correctly depending on the exact Pro system you have to make sure the WaterSecure is large enough. The final and most common usage is to take our existing AC pump off grid and run it off of solar and batteries. So when the grid goes down, our water keeps pumping. I'm going to give you a quick overview on how to set this up and get your well pump off grid. If you have a little bit of electrical knowledge, you can wire in an AC outlet to the output of the WaterSecure. That allows you to plug in your well pump. But at the same time, you can also use your 110 volt loads. If you're not familiar with this, we can help walk you through it. Otherwise, it might be best to call an electrician. They can help set up a little AC box next to your WaterSecure so you can plug in your small AC loads. As I mentioned, WaterSecure comes pre-wired with 220 volt AC input and output plugs. So we have our female, which is our output. That's what we're gonna be plugging our load into. And we have our male, which is our inlet, and this is optional. WaterSecure does not require AC input, but it's nice to have. In case you have extended cloudy days and you aren't able to charge your battery bank, you can either plug this into a generator and recharge your battery bank, or you can hook it up to grid power, and the unit will auto-transfer over to grid power when the batteries get depleted and there's not enough sun to recharge them. It opens up a lot of options, and so it's nice to be able to charge or operate off the grid. So let's grab our wire and our connectors, and we're gonna head on over to our well control box in order to get it wired up. Now, a bit of caution, if you're not familiar with AC power, then you might wanna get a professional installer and a professional electrician to come help you do these connections. Once they make the initial connections and hook up your plugs, then it's very easy to plug and unplug everything. First thing, we're gonna wanna power down our breaker. I've already done that, so the wires are safe to work with. And so let's head on over to the control box and wire up our male plug so we can plug it into WaterSecure. If you have a three-wire submersible well pump, then you're gonna have a control box located somewhere near the wellhead or in your pump house. If you have what's called a two-wire pump, then you're not gonna have this control box, but very likely you're gonna have a set of AC breakers located somewhere around the well pump in order to hook up your wires to. So we've gone ahead and we have our AC input here from, in this case, grid power, and we put on our female plug and wired that up here. Before we did that, we turned off the breaker so it's all safe and we're not having any live wires. Now this is a temporary installation, so we are using just plain electrical cord in order to do all these connections. But if you're doing a permanent install, then you're gonna wanna do it in conduit with this nice stranded wire. So we have our AC input hooked up here. This, like I said earlier, is optional for WaterSecure. You don't have to have the AC input, but it's very nice in case you need to transfer back over to AC power. Say you're doing a lot of watering, we have an extended cloudy days, and your battery bank gets depleted. Now, for our three-wire pump, we're gonna remove the cover. And I've already got this partly set up. We have our two wires here, which are actually running up through our conduit to our pressure switch. Then it goes back through the pressure switch to line one, line two. Since we still want our pressure switch installed, we're gonna hook up to the two input wires going up to our pressure switch. To do that, we have our piece of our electrical cord, and they previously used wire nuts, so we're gonna reuse these wire nuts in the same configuration they did. So we have our two hot wires connected up to our hot input going up to the pressure switch and our ground wire hooked up. Obviously, like I mentioned, if this is a permanent install, you're gonna wanna use conduit here. And at the very least, you're gonna use a stress relief. So if this wire is getting pulled on, we're not pulling our electrical connections. For now, we're just leaving it as be. On our other side, we need to hook up our included 220 volt connector. We're using three strand wire. The nice thing about WaterSecure, so it's what's called split phase inverter. So it has two 110 volt lines, and between the 110 volt lines, we can get our 220 volt AC output. This is just like the power going to your house. So we just mimic that going into our control box. So in this case, we have three wires, but our connector has four. We're just not gonna use this center one, which is for our neutral, because with our 220 volt pump, we don't need a neutral. We need our two hots and our ground. So let's go ahead, get this hooked up so we can plug it on into our WaterSecure. There are three wires wired into our male plug. So you can see here, the one with the little notch, that's our ground. The screw is also green, so that's gonna go to our ground wire. And then two on either side are our line one, line two hot wires. The third one here is our neutral. And in this case, the neutral is not being used. We've got them all in the connector nicely secured, and we can put the housing on. Thank you. So we have our male plugged hooked up to our control box, which goes down into our well pump. We also have our female plug here, which is going to utility power. The nice thing is, if you ever need to bypass the WaterSecure system, you simply unplug from WaterSecure, you can plug it straight back into utility power. But right now, let's go ahead, we're gonna plug into our WaterSecure and fire up our pump. So with everything connectorized, getting your well pump running on WaterSecure is as simple as turning on our WaterSecure unit, and then plugging in our well pump into WaterSecure. It's kind of hard to tell, but I can notice the pump has started up and it's starting to fill up the pressure in our pressure tank. And if we go over here, give it a second, see, we do have well pump pressure and we're getting our water currently off the grid without AC hooked up. Now, if you do want to hook up AC, it's as simple as taking our male cord and plugging it into our AC supply. So we have our AC output from WaterSecure plugged into our well pump. That's all running correctly. Now let's talk about backup options, either if you want to hook it up to utility power or up to a generator. So coming out of WaterSecure is another male plug. And from here, we can either plug it into our AC utility power. And what that's going to do is if the batteries get too depleted, it's going to transfer over to AC power until the sun comes back up and charges up the batteries. Then it's going to switch back to battery power in order to take your well pump back off the grid. Now that's not required, but it is a nice feature, that auto transfer, so you don't have to worry about extended cloudy days in order to keep your water flowing. Now if you don't have utility power, no problem, you can also use a generator. A majority of the 220 volt generators have this exact same input plug on them, so all we have to do is take our male plug, hook it up to our generator, fire it up, and in this case, the load's gonna run off the generator, and if we need to, we can charge the battery bank off of the generator, get it all back fully charged in a matter of an hour or two, and then disconnect our generator and start running off of batteries again. And hopefully the sun comes up and it's gonna keep those batteries charged. But it gives a lot of nice versatile options in order to keep your water flowing, whether the grid is active or the grid is not active. If you need one of these systems, give us a call. We have them in stock, ready to ship today. We'll help size them for your pump. We have a couple of different sizes. We have a 3,000 watt, a 6,000 watt, and a 12,000 watt that will run up to around a 2 or 3 horsepower pump, depending on your exact supply. We also can help out if you need to run small electrical loads, like lights and fridges, along with your well pump. So we can help you size it and figure out what system is going to work for your exact water needs. If you want to give us a call at 888-637-4493 or visit us at rpssolarpumps.com.